Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. We are taking a video on programming in C. So we are taking, now we are discussing about C tokens. We have different types of key tokens. They are keywords, identifiers, literals, string operators, and separators. Let us move into the section. So C tokens, only one topic we are presenting here. So a token is the smallest element of a program that is meaningful to the compiler. So they are keywords, identifiers, literals, also called as constants, strings, special symbols, also called as separators, and operators. Now let them know one by one. The first one is keywords. Keywords are predefined or reserved words in a programming language. Each keyword is meant to perform a specific function in a program. Since keywords are referred names for a compiler, they cannot be used as variable names, because by doing so, we are trying to assign a new meaning to the keyword, which is not allowed. You cannot redefine keywords. However, you can specify text to be substituted for keywords before compilation by using C or C++ preprocessor derivatives. C language supports 32 keywords, which are given below: auto, break, case, char, constant, continue, default, do, double, else, enum, extern, float, for, go to, if, int, long, register, return, short, signed, size of, static, struct, switch, typedef, union, unsigned, void, volatile, while. So they are 32. There are 32 keywords. The next one is identifiers. Identifiers are used for the general terminology for naming of variables, functions, and arrays. These are user-defined names consisting of arbitrary long sequence of letters and digits with either a letter or the underscore as a first character. Identifier names must differ in spelling and case from any keywords. You cannot use keywords as identifiers. They are reserved for special use. Once declared, you can use the identifier in later program statements to refer to them associated value. A special kind of identifier called a statement label can be used in go to statements. So there are certain rules that should be followed while naming C identifiers. They must begin with a letter capital A to Z, small a to Z, or underscore. They must consist of only letters capital A to Z, small a to Z, digits 0 to 9, and underscore. No other special characters are allowed. It should not be a keyword. It must not contain white space. It should be up to 31 characters long, as only first 31 characters are significant. Literals, also called as constants. Constants are also like normal variables, but only difference is either values cannot be modified by the program once they are defined. Constants refer to fixed values. They are also called as literals. Constants may belonging to any of the data types. Syntax, const, data type, variable name. Okay, if you declare as a variable, constant, data type, pointer, variable name. So types of constants: integer constants, real or floating point constants, octal and hexadecimal constants, character constants, and string constants. String constants are indicated with double quotes. Character constants are indicated with single quote. Hexa is before zero. Sorry, zero capital X, zero small x. And octa is zero. And real numbers normally we can represent, and these are represented in normal. So strings. Strings are nothing but an array of characters ended with a null character. This null character indicates the end of the string. Strings are also always enclosed in double quotes. whereas a character is enclosed in a single quote in C language. So special symbols. The following special symbols are used in C having some special meaning and thus cannot be used for some other purposes. So the special symbols are this. The first one is brackets. Opening and closing brackets are used as array element reference. These indicate single and multi-dimensional subscripts. Parentheses. These special symbols are used to indicate function calls and function parameters. Braces. These opening and ending curly braces marks the start and end of the block of code containing more than one executable statement. Comma. It is used to separate more than one statement, like for separating parameters in function calls. So the next is semicolon. It is an operator that essentially invokes something called an initialization list. Asterisk, it is used to create pointer variable. Assignment operators, it is used to assign values. Preprocessor, the preprocessor is a macro processor that is used automatically by the compiler to transform your program before actual compilation. Now, operators. Operators are symbols that triggers an action when applied to C, variables and other objects. The data items on which operators act upon are called operands. They are generally classified into three categories based on number of operands. Unary operator. Those operators that require only single operand to act upon are known as unary operators. For example, increment by decrement operators. Second one is binary operators. Those operators that require two operands to act upon are called binary operators. They are arithmetic operators, relational operators, logical operators, assignment operators, conditional operators, and bitwise operators. And finally, ternary operators. These operators require three operands to act upon. For example, it is conditional operator.